Hello YouTube, viewers, subscribers, and everybody else remaining. Social Network, CB6 Dark King, and today we're going to do a new Let's Play for Mod Masters. And this is not going to be the only one for this brand new series I'm starting. I'm doing not one, not two, but three full-blown series for Mod Masters. So, what's Mod Masters? Well, the name says it all. Is a put a game heavily modded to, well, heavily is relatively speaking, but modded to a certain extent, and well, you're going to see the result. The three games I'll be doing are Stellaris, Synthetic Dawn, Sci-Fi at War, which is the combination of over 150 mods coupled together and somehow not crashing the game. Oh, you don't know. You have no idea what I had to go through to get this working. Total War, Warhammer 2, Mortal Empires with the Empire, a series that should be up in about half an hour. The first episode, and Empire at War, Force of Corruption, Republic at War, to be precise. The mod of the Clone Wars. So, these three, the first episodes, episode 0 of Stellaris and episode 1 of Total Warhammer 2 Mortal Empires and Republic at War for Mod Masters will all be released at the same time, EGE, today. And well, then is one day, one episode of each series. So, day 1 Stellaris, day 2 Total War, day 3 Republic at War, and so on and so forth. So, now that you get the picture, let's get to it. So, this is episode 0. This is where I explain to you how this is going to work. Basically, I've made a total of 34 races for this whole Sci-Fi at War mess, because trust me, it's going to be a mess, and it's going to be a fun mess. Well, first of all, let's introduce the contestants. We have the Cylons and the Colonials from Battlestar Galactica, obviously. They're using Wormhole because, well, if you watch the series, their FTL gems are basically work as homeworld, as a home. Dang it. Wormhole. Shit, I said homeworld. Really? A wormhole works. One moment you're here, boop, the other moment you're somewhere else. It doesn't work as like hyperspace or warp. So, and of course the Cylons are using missiles, because, well, duh, they're the Cylons. That's their whole gist. And swarm tactics, because they're heavy use of fighters. They're of course divided because the whole 8 numbers don't necessarily like each other. They're machine conscious, and I've played a bit with the lore here. They're rogue saboteurs. This is a universe where someone rebelled, but they didn't want to exterminate humanity, just, you know, do that programming of serving them in a more extreme way. This is a stretch, but I'm using the whole mission in Battlestar Galactica Deadlock, where the one leader said she wanted to continue the war so that both races evolved. On a related note, the ships of the Cylons and the Colonials are from Battlestar Galactica Deadlock. And boy, do they look good. On the Colonial side, well, they're industrious talented deviants. Yeah, they are, most definitely. Self-sufficient and non-adaptive. Because, well, the 12 colonies of Kobol were good at what they did, but the Cylon mess was quite literally a mess. They use mass drivers, obviously. That's their whole thing. Galactica's weapons are railguns, so it works perfectly. And the wormhole tech again. Again, from Deadlock, the point-to-point-to-point is almost exactly how wormholes work here. Then we have from Eve, and again, I'm stretching the lore a bit, almost to breaking point. We have the Minotaur Republic. Like, these guys. Sorry. They again use the wormhole, in this case, is the whole acceleration gate from Eve. Warcrafters, because. Well, just look at the lore of Eve, they're rebels. Individualists, materialists, militarists, xenophobic, because their history, and they're egalitarian. Then we have the Galactic Federation. These guys are basically the free haven of this thing. And. Let me say, the whole Stargate backgrounds just fit so well with the elementals. I don't know why, maybe it's the blue lights. Anyway, they use the Galleon ships, red lasers, and again, the acceleration gates. Then, we have the capitalistic Caldarian... Caldari state. Is of mass drivers, one world, once again. They're divided because it's every corporation for itself. Relatively weak, because I'm using the huts as a stand-in. They got slavers because the employees are basically indoctrinated from birth to do their best. Innovative economy, server economy, because again, indoctrination, and heavily bureaucratic, because they're basically an amalgamation of super corporations. Extreme authoritarian, extreme materialist, and quite a bit industrialist. Also, this is one of the mods. It increases by 2 and by 1. It's quite an interesting and highly... Actually, let me show you. It adds quite a few and increases this one as well, along with other mods. The civics, and it adds one more. Also, HUDs on a medicine world. It just fits. Then we have the... Another empire. The Inflorations is, if I remember the lore well, they're the biggest faction in EVE. Aristocratic elite, and nationalistic. They're authoritarian, xenophobe, fanatic materialists, and collectivists. With nuclear missiles, once again the wormhole, and the armed ships. All for new ships and more. Slaver, obnoxious, because, well, the way they act, nobody like it. They can have slavers, however, they're intelligent survivalists. Then we have the Lycan tribe. What are Lycans, you may ask? Basically the catch-all term for canine furries. Think Fox McCloud and Crystal from Star Fox and pretty much that. So, they are tribal. That's the name. So they have a ring of elders, an environmental economy, and they work towards inward perfection. They're xenophobe, basically they don't trust anybody else. Pacifistic, spiritualists, and fanatically ecologists. They were born in a lush tropical world and they like it like that. Also, they use biological ships and construction methods. However, yeah, they can last. Do your own fanfics. And the tribes mean they're relatively divided and they like to fight. Not so much like, still more along the like tradition to fight each other. They use warp drives because, well, it fits. As far as nuclear missiles, remember, they're bioships, so these missiles would be like... think the Tyranny's bioform just ramming into the Imperial ships. These missiles would be something akin to living creatures just ramming. Practice courage, basically. Then we have the Elven Worlds, your local space elves. Give me a second. Whoops. Huh. Well, my mistake. Which one? There we go. I think it was an error in the mod. Anyway, these are basically the Eldar, or the Space Elves. Again, society, aristocratic elite, and heavy influential. With Red Razor, hyperspace travel, because again, Eldar, AGE, the Webway, and using elven ships. There we go, Italian pacifists and spiritualists. However, they're fanatic elitists with the classic, oh, we're space elves, we're better than everybody else. Oh, the classics. So, the communal decadent beauty, heavily influenced by personal appearance. Psychic gifted, again, influenced by the Eldar, Elven. They're elves, duh. And conservationist. Ah, I can't talk. And the background that I just added fits rather well. Desert habitat with a lush, beautiful tree line in the background. Then we have the System Alliance from Mass Effect, with the System Alliance ships, mass drives, just like in Mass Effect, and wormhole travel. This representing the mass, the guys that provide the... Oh, I can't believe I'm forgetting the name. It will come to me. Anyway, their technocracy with civil service and with military, since that's the whole thing with Shepard. Mass relays! There! Man, it was hard. Anyway, their egalitarian militaries, materialists, militarists, because, well, after the First Contact War, they kinda had to be. And, you know, tradition at this point. Individualists and egalitarian. The Wiso. They're relatively united. Because, again, after the First Contact War, they have to be. Deviants, because, well, see, we're humans, we don't really get along. Still, our bad habits dying hard, they were relatively aggressive, intelligent, and talented. Then we have, from Star Trek, the Terran Empire, with warp, pew pew lasers, and the TGN ships. They're a military dictatorship, while binding nihilists. Heavily authoritarian, fanatic xenophobes, and fanatic militarists. They're brutal, non-adaptive, again, human. Relative intelligence, extremely combative, however, self-sufficient, because they have to be. In the environment that they have, since, you know, they're not a federation, they can't actually rely on allies, they have to be self-sufficient. Then we have the Hull Rift, and these are just the devouring swarm. Quite literally. They're the horrors of creation that will suck your life. They use some more travel because of the whole boop and out of reality. I'm not using hyperspace because that's a whole different thing. These Elsier Dart ships, again, organic ships to mush. They're Divine Swarms, Strength in Legion, and One Might. So, they are hive-minded, astral horrors, obviously, very strong, edgy, because just fits, cannibalistic, little boars, and death. Just death incarnate. Then from Stargate, we have the Shuren Empire, you know, the replicators. They use warp, because even in the show they call it hyperspace, let's face it, it's warp. You pop in, then you pop out whenever you want. Just like warp here. There's no lines, no lanes, no gates. It's not a Stargate, but that's a whole different mess. They use nuclear missiles, basically the drones, and use student ships. They're identified for fanatic militaries because they're a weapon of mass. They were created as a weapon, and they're fanatic materialists. Sorry. Because due to the cold, all they did was be stuck on the planets building stuff. Without much else to do. Ancient knowledge, because descendant of the ancients. Enlightened, again, descendant of the ancients. And assimilationists, because the cold. Again, assimilationists. Exterminators, just go see the whole Ashuran War in Stargate Atlantis. Ashuran replicators, self-sufficient, because they're extremely self-sufficient in the show. It even isn't funny. And, well, they're replicators, so they're obviously extremely adaptive. Then we have their daddies, the Ancient Empire. With the ancient cities, some beautiful background, and the same setup because, well, it fits. Again, with the drones. They're egalitarian xenophiles, fanatic materialists, and heavily industrialists. Considering the things that they build, sorry, you wouldn't be surprised. They are so heavily influential since they're basically the oldest or the second oldest species in the Stargate universe. Ancient knowledge, because, well, they're the ancients. And watching monuments. Just look at Atlantis. Then, obviously, they're the ancient. A word we call the past. I'm not sure, because, well, they're kind of elitist. I didn't put it here because, well, they are, but the fanatical materialists just fit better. Self-sufficient and relatively weak, because, well, most of them still didn't have their superpowers. Or that we see in some of episodes of Stargate Atlantis. Also, they lost to the race. More on them right there. Then we have the ones we're playing with, the Ashuran Beta. Once again, we have the same setup as far as weapons and warp as the ancient and the OG Ashuran. However, I'm using the AI ships. The whole history here is that the ancients built a second planet with replicators, however, in a different model. These ones, after also being just as well destroyed as the OG Assurance, e.g. not really, developed in a different way. Errors and bugs in their code allowed them to evolve to a fanatically hating machine conscience that wants everybody dead. And they're termed exterminators, obviously, rapid replicators, because, well, they're replicators, duh. And built to last, since, well, the ancients tried to wipe them out and kind of failed. They're a machine, mass produced again. They're replicators. They produce fast, again. They're Ashuran replicators, super luxurious, because we all know that the ancients spare no expense, and durable, again. They tried to wipe them out and failed miserably. Then, we jump to 40k with the Imperium of Men, currently being led by Papa Smurf him freaking self. The Primarch of the Ultramarines, Reboot Gilliman. Honestly, he's one of my favorites. I always like those characters that are good statesmen, with a just fitting background for it. I'm using mass drives because that's the whole macro guns, although the Imperium doesn't really pick and choose. With, as long as it creates really, really big bangs, the Imperium is okay with the weapon. Then we have hyperspace travel, because in the warp you follow lanes, not as defined as the webway, but you still need to follow the currents. And of course, the Imperial ships. So, Ultramarine philosophy, since the Ultra Smurfs are the ones in charge, since their Primarch got awoken through some BS Aldar magic, thingamajigs, and a suit of armor that they could have in no way known should be prepared, since, well, as far as we know, Rebooty wasn't a Psyker, or at least not a Psyker reactivated as Magnus or Volgar. Anyway, the Imperial Code, since, as far as I know, Rebooty hasn't done anything at all to disband it, and anarchic society. After 10,000 years, you can expect that. They're authoritarian, duh. Extremely xenophobic, heavy materialists, and a fanatic spiritualist. Again, with the whole Imperial cult. Then, we have post-human, with the whole space marine things. Loyalists, obviously. That's the whole gist of the Horus Heresy, is the loyalists versus the traitors. Servants, because servants of the Emperor. Fanatical, need I repeat myself. Brutal, just go read 40k, the Imperium is not a place you want to live. And exterminators, because press the exterminators button, just go watch If the Emperor Had Tested Peace Device, that's one of the best series on YouTube. It's frenetically hilarious. Then we have the Galactic Republic, and this is the old Galactic Republic from, well, the Old Republic. With the Old Republic ships, hyperspace travel, because in the Star Wars unit there are hyperspace lanes, even though the movies wouldn't tell you that. With the pew pew lasers, they're egalitarian, fanatic xenophobic, spiritualist, because the whole Jedi Order, and industrialist, because just look at Coruscant. A free haven and a beacon of liberty, because that's what the Republic should be. And they're heavily influential, because of, well, the size of the Republic in the lore. They're apathetic, they like peace. It's different, again, the Republic. Urban, again, look at Coruscant, heavily industrious, and kind of wasteful. Again, just go look at the droid factories in episode 2 and how Kurzan looks, they are quite wasteful. Then, going back to the grim darkness of the far future, we have Chaos. With the Godic ships, because, well, most of the Chaotic ships are Capture Imperials ships, although they have their own models. And they are using red lasers because, unlike the Imperials, the Chaos fleet concentrates more on long-range lances, lances being lasers. This is all 40k. Again, hyperspace. They are authoritarians. Well, no duh. Fanatic materialists and fanatic spiritualists because all hail the Chaos Gods. Then, Warcrafters. I don't think I need to explain that. Elite militaries because even though we joke about Philbadon the Harmless, most of these guys have been fighting for over 10,000 years. And survivor economy because we'll go read a book about the Chaos Invasion. It's not beautiful. It's not pretty. Post-human again, they are the ultimate life forms, with all the angst and edge that comes with it, since, well, the Chaos Gods kinda made sure of it. They are extremely divided because, let me just put it this way, the different Chaos Warbands hate each other just as much as they hate the Imperium. Slavers, again, just explained it, they are exterminators because, well, again, just go read the lore. They have no pity and no mercy, and they are abominations. Just look at Papa Nurgle, and you shouldn't need anything else. Then, jumping ship again, we go to the Covenant. With the Covenant ships, the Red Lasers, again, was with the Stargate. When I started. Dang it. That's Raves. Where did I put it? I could have sworn I had already changed this one. There. I'm putting it to space because it's High Charity. However, remember, High Charity is a space station, and that's where they start. They start at the habitat. Their homeworld. There we go. Name and class. They started an orbital habitat, e.g. High Charity. They are fanatic materialists, fanatic spiritualists, and elitists. Again, they think they deserve everything that the Forerunners left. And they are the chosen one, and all those around them should just follow their lead. Safe space is basically the same, works the same way as warp here. Covenant ships, red lasers, because they specialize in energy weapons. Exalted priesthood, they are. This is because of the elites. It's and the divine circle again with the prophets. They are loyalists, exterminators, because, well, just look at their bad habit of glassing planets. Scavengers, in the sense that they scavenge for everything that the Forerunners left. Fanatical, and servants, because, again, obviously. Then we have, also from Halo, the United Nations Space Command, or the UNSC. They also use split space, with UNSC weapons and mass drives, because mech guns are fun. The egalitarian fanatic materialists because, well, their experience with the Covenant. Materialists and egalitarians, doubly so. They have elite militaries, just look at the Spartans and the and Commander Cold for examples. Innovative economy because, well, we still had free market there, if I'm not mistaken. And mechanists because they have absolutely no qualms with AI, and drones. They are industrious, intelligent, and scavengers. Just look at that production. At the beginning of the war, it was super massive. Halsey, as far as a good example of intelligence, and scavengers because they are also after the stuff that the Forerunners left. They're rebels because look at the insurrection, and non-adaptive because they're still humans. Then, back to Star Trek, we have the Federation, and these guys are the Federation, led by the Vulcans. So, warp, lasers, and fed ships. The Altarian Fanatic Xenophobes and Fanatic Pacifists, being a free haven, a peaceful commonwealth of the different species, and a beacon of liberty. That does have the consequences of a static society, soul breeders. This is, I think, something that has more to do with the society. They are extremely united, relatively weak, because don't let Star Trek Discovery fool you. The Klingons don't really lose to humans, and they're highly intelligent. Then we have one of my personal creations, the Demi-Demons. These bad boys are, well, kinda the pick your favorite anime demon, and that's pretty much it. The hyperspace, red laser, and the dark and avian ships, because once you see it, you'll see it just fits so well. They are fanatic authoritarian, fanatic militarists, and spiritualists, because all hail the demon king, and they just want to rape everybody, so every economy, because trust me, you don't want to be under their rule, even pretty. Warcrafters and anarchist society, again, they're ancient. They're brutal, relatively divided, because demons don't like each other. Invasive, because, again, demons. Psychic gifted, demons, once again. And decadent slavers, because, again, you don't want to be under their rule. Then we go to the pirates, RG mateys, led by Captain Harlock, him freaking self. Not learned. Arlok. They use hyperspace. I'm taking the ships kind of from Star Wars. That's why they go through hyperspace. Also using mice drivers. Because, well, let's face it, it's the less complex of all the types of weapons. They are fanatic militarists since, well, they're pirates. Their whole thing is wreck everybody else. Xenophobic, materialist, and industrialist, since, well, after you capture a ship, you need to do something with it. Warcrafters, industrial economy, and elite militaries, because if you're not good at a good pirate, you're not living very long. Again, a pirate. They're brutal scavengers, highly self-sufficient, because, again, they have to be, they're pirates. And decadent slavers, because, well, if you're unlucky enough to be captured by the pirates, and they don't like you enough to be added to the crew, let's just say your life is hell. Then we have the Rebel Alliance from Star Wars. Hyperspace Lions, like I said, the Pew Pew Lasers, and the Rebel Ships. They're fanatic egalitarian, fanatic xenophiles, and spirits, because again, the Jedi. A free haven, a beacon of liberty, and a meritocracy, because to fight the Empire, they had to be. They are highly pathetic, divided, because just look at Rogue One and the whole Chinook and men not being respected thing. Rebels, because, well, they're the Rebel Alliance. Self-sufficient, because again, that's a necessity against the Empire. And highly opportunist, because that's the only way they can fight such a massive force. Oxygen! We then proceed to Stargate again with the Tauri. Led by the, as far as we know, last commander of the SGC. Last as in the season 10 of Stargate SG-1. We go with the mass drivers because, well, that's what they used before the Asgard showed how to make the beam weapons. Warp drive because that's basically hyperspace, that's how it works. And of course the Tauri ships. And I've played with this. They are a lot of fun. They got their xenophile, they like peace, materialists, and highly individualists. A beacon of liberty and a free haven, and heavily meritocratic, because in SGC, if you're not good, you're not in the SGC. Basically, the SG teams were elites. Well, elites, they had to be. They, of course, Atari, unpredictable, just look at the series, highly intelligent, although not adaptive, and the scavengers, because, well, the whole point of the SGC was to gather technology. Also, I'm going to put them in Atlantis. Just for this. That's the ocean world. They did some renovating and not terraforming, adding more cities to the planet. Then we have the Dark Elves. Quite literally the edgy G-slavers that we all know and love. Dark Elven. Then with the red lasers, again they use a web light. The Elven ships with the whole red ominous lighting. They are quite elitist, militarist, because, well, they need slaves. It's a category with the fair economy and inwards perfection because, well, they're narcissistic to a fault. Well, how xenophobic, because, again, they think they're the best there are and they deserve all your services for no payment at all. They're militarist because, well, you need to raid to get slaves. And materialist because, again, they're the Dark Eldar. They lack stuff. Then, going right back to Stargate, we have the System Lords. Earths using the low ships with warp, because again, that's how hyperspace works. Earths in Stargate. And they use energy weapons, but they're not lasers. They're energy blasts, so the mass travel just fit better. They're to the wall. They're Tartarians, xenophobe militarists, and fanatically elitist, because I am God, and you shall bow to me. That's basically what the Goa'uld are. They're slave economy because, well, that whole point, Jafar were their slaves, and that's the whole mentality. A Warlord Council, e.g. the System Wars in of themselves, and Warcrafters, because, well, they fight among themselves as much as they fought everybody else. They're Goa'uld, parasitic, because they're parasites that's imbued into your brain, and took your body. Scavengers, again, going after what the ancients left and everybody else had to give. Taken enslavers because they're the Goa'uld. Just go watch the series. Adaptive, because the Goa'uld are extremely adaptive. They needed a host, but after that the host was better. Stronger. Smarter, not necessary. And they're extremely divided because, again, the system will really, really hate each other. Then we have the Free Jaffa Nation, EGE. The Jaffa said, screw that, we're going to form our own nation and take all your stuff. That's why the setup is the exact same as far as chips go. They got to fanatic militarists because, well, they were the warrior race of the Goa'uld. Spiritualists because all the habits die hard. And heavily individualists because after serving in false gods for so long, they got kind of sick of it. They became a liberty, a martial democracy, and war crafters because, again, they were the warrior race. They Jaffa, obviously. Combative inept because, again, they were bred to fight, not research technology. They're highly adaptive, again, faster, stronger, better. And the scavengers because, A, they want all the gold stuff, and they also, after what the Tower V and the ancients had to offer. Then, still Stargate, we go to the race. They are a hive-minded, the bioship using parasites. And again, the mass drives, I know it's plasma, but I can't start with plasma. They use the warp drives. They are a devouring swarm, literally. They suck your soul for all intents and purposes. Strengthening Legion, because that's the whole point, that's how they won the war against the ancients. And free nodes. Oh, in the sense that each queen is the leader of its own hive. Hive Mandate, they are the race, obviously. Abhorrent, let's face it, nobody likes them. They use bio-constructed and bio-ships. Parasites, exterminators, just go watch yourself, they don't get around. And Wavevoort, they can quite literally suck the life out of pretty much anything that isn't immune to it. And last, but definitely not least, we have the Asari from Mass Effect again. Again, with the Mass Relays, Mass Drives, and the Asari Fleets. They are heavily guaranteed, fanatic, xenophobic, quite spiritualist, and elitist, because just play the games, they are kind of jerks. Radical Evolution, that's their whole gist. Bureaucratics, and a free haven, because they're still a good democracy despite their elitism. Psychic Gifting, because of all the whole biotics thing. They're relatively united. Hedonistic, they are, just go play the games, you can see it. Genetics, that's the way they reproduce. They take the traits and then, boop, there's a new Asari. And they're urban. Again, just go play the games. You can see it in their cities. And that's it. That's episode 0 of both this one this Let's Play of Stellaris Sci-Fi at War, or and the other two. So, this is going to go today, while the first three episodes are going to go tomorrow. I think I mispronounced this at the beginning of the video. You. Anyway, now you know what to expect. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this, and until next time... Oh, wait, before I forget, what a moron. The setting. We're going to be doing better with the whole, you failed to destroy us, now you're going to regret it. And this is what we're going to do. 2,000 stars with the 4th Spiral Galaxy, 50 Empires, e.g. my 34 plus 16. No AI starters. There's 2 Fallen Empires, because there's a glitch which gives the Fallen Empires huge territories, even though they have the exact same number of planets, so 2 is the maximum I can afford. Primitive civilization is the usual, twice the power of the crisis, the usual number of habitable worlds, AI aggression I put in normal because I don't want the other 16 to all be fanatic purifiers, that's the thing that happens. On hard mode, any of the old method, a random placement of the empires because cluster doesn't make any sense, and no advanced neighbors. I wanted everybody to be on the same footing. So, people, that's the premise. I hope you enjoyed it, and until episode 1 of both this Let's Play of Stellaris Sci-Fi at War, or and the other two, Republic at War and Total War Warhammer 2 Mortal Empires, I hope you have a nice day, hope you enjoyed it, don't forget to like, subscribe, and well, we know the drill. Until next time, I'll see you around. Ta-ta!